Welcome back, dear children. Let us begin with the next part. My dear children, in the previous part, we have learnt about adaptation in animals, meaning of adaptation, and we have also learnt about adaptation of animals that live in water. All right. Now, in this next part, we will learn about the adaptation in animals that live in deserts. A desert is a place that gets very little rain. Hence, deserts are generally rocky or sandy with very few plants and animals. So, a desert is a place which get very little rain. And because these places get little rains, what happens? They are generally rocky or sandy, pathreela, rocky. Lots of sand is present in those places. All right. And very few animals are found in these places. Deserts can be hot and cold, but we will talk about adaptations in animals that live in hot deserts. My dear children, deserts, they can be even hot. They can even be hot or cold. But in this lesson, we will learn about adaptation in animals that live in hot places. And hot deserts, the temperature is very high. All right. Even higher than the temperature that you face during the summer season. Just imagine, it would be so difficult to live in those places where the temperatures are much higher. So, my dear children, in this lesson, the best example of the animal that lives in desert is camel. All right, let us read about the features that are present in camel. God has made certain body parts of the camel which enables them to live in deserts. Let us see. The inner lining of the hair protects its ear from sand. Because camel lives in desert place, it lives in area where lots of sand is present. The inner lining of the ears, inside the ears there are small hairs present, okay, which protects its ears from the sand. So when the sand will blow, camel's ear will be protected from the sand due to the presence of the lining of hair inside the ear. Lining of hair means kaan ke andar mein small hairs are present. Understood? Okay, and if these hairs are present, what they will do? They will trap the sand. What sand ko pakad lega? It will not allow the sand to go inside the body of the camel. I hope you have understood. Next. Long lashes protects the camel's eye from the blowing sand. Long eyelashes. Eyelashes, you know what are eyelashes? You also have eyelashes? Similarly, the camel's eyelashes are very long. Okay, and it protects the camel's eye from blowing sand. So when the sand will blow, these eyelashes will protect. So because the sand will enter the eye, then it will be difficult. When something enters your eye, how difficult it is to open your eye or to look something. Yes or no? So God has made some long lashes in camel's eye. Naturally it is present, which prevents the camel's eye from the blowing sand. Okay. A camel can close its nostrils to keep out the sand. We can't close our nostril, but the camels can. They can close their nostril so that when the sand will blow, it cannot enter the body of the camel. Okay? Next. Thick lips helps a camel munch thorny plant that grow in deserts. They have a thick lip. Thick lips means they have thick lips, which means when they eat thorny plant, kaatedar thorny plant like cactus and all, okay, they can easily eat those plants. These plants grow in desert, and so the camels, they can easily eat and they can easily munch those thorny plant, easily chew those thorny plants. Let us move forward. It has thick fur to protect it from the heat and cold. My dear children, in the desert places, during the daytime, it is hot. But at night, it is very cold. Do you know why? Because the desert places, sand is present. And this sand, it gets quickly heated up in the sunlight. And at night, it gets quickly cooled also. And because it gets quickly cooled, the temperature at night is very cold. So in the desert area, the temperature is very hot during the day and it is very cold at night. So camel, they have a thick fur to protect it from the heat and cold. The body is covered with a thick fur. Okay, so that camel is protected from heat and cold. A camel can go without water for days. Its hump has stored fat, which it uses when it does not get food. Camels have a very good quality that they can go without water for days. Even if they do not get water, they can live without water for many days. We people can't do this, yes or no? If you will not get water for many days, you will surely know, it would be very difficult for us. If we people will not get water for many days, we will surely die. But camel, they can live without water for days. So this is also one of the adaptation of the camel, which enables them to live in the hot place. Another one is that its hump has stored fat. Can you see the hump? When the camel, there is a hump. Okay, in this hump, they store fat. Fat is stored, which it uses when it does not get food. So, when the camel does not get food, they want energy. From where they will get energy? They will get energy from the stored fat. Okay, next, it does not lose much water in the form of urine and sweat. Because camel lives in the hot places, they do not lose much water in the form of urine or sweat. Okay, if they will lose, then it would be difficult for them to live without water. I hope you have understood. Okay, next. A camel can drink a lot of water at one go. It can drink lots of water at one go. At one go means at a time. It can drink lots and lots of water. And because of this, it can live without water for many days. Next. Long legs keeps it high above the hot sand. Because they have long legs, my dear children, because they have long legs, they can easily walk on sand. Alright, they can easily walk on sand. Walk on sand means, because you just imagine, you try to walk on sand, your leg will go inside. Alright. And it would be very difficult for us to walk on sand. It is difficult, in fact. Okay, whenever there is a building construction going on and there is some sand kept outside that building, you try to walk on that sand. It is difficult to walk on the sand. Yes or no, my dear children? Similarly, but camel, they can easily walk on sand. They have long legs so that they can remain above this hot sand. Okay, I hope you have understood. A camel's feet are wide, so its legs do not sink in the sand. If you will walk on the sand, your legs will go inside. Lekin, camel's feet, they are wide enough, so they can easily walk on the sand. That is why camels are known as what? They are known as the ship of the deserts. Alright, it is mostly used as a means of transportation in the desert places. Because in the desert places, cars, bus, scooters, these cannot run properly. And camel can easily walk on the sand. God has made its feet and legs in such a way that it can easily walk on sand. So these were the adaptive features of the camel. How camel can easily adapt itself, can adjust itself in the desert place. How do other animals survive in desert? In general, they stay in the shade during the day and feed at night. Some make homes underground where it is cooler, as in the basement. Some even go into a sleepy state in the summer and become active when it rains or becomes cooler. So, my dear children, there are some other desert animals also. So what they do? They stay in the shade during the day when it is very hot, and they feed at night. Okay, there are some animals who remain underground where it is cooler, under the ground or basement. Some even go into the sleepy state in the summer. They sleep during the summer season and they become active when it rains and becomes cooler. So my dear children, I hope you have understood. This was about the adaptation of animals that live in desert. In the next part, I will teach about adaptation of animals that live in cold places. So please read this properly. Thank you.